Hi, hi, hi. Hello there, everybody. I just found myself. I just have to check if all my sounds are off. I think so. So, welcome. Yes, it is a mixed media tutorial. Hi, Bafani. I hope I'm pronouncing all the names right. Afreen, hi. Oh my goodness. Well, I've got all my stuff here. Started anything? No, I'm just going to start. This is my example. I thought it would be nice to show. This is what we're going to do today. And I have to make some room here. What am I going to use? The texture paste. I've got the art gel medium. I've got the dimensional heavy gel. I have some deco stones. Got some metallic colors, and my hands are too small. My hands are never too small. Two colors of chalk paint. Got some beautiful chipboards. Of course, we're gonna need a canvas, stencil. And what else do I got? Have I got? I think it is. I got some lace, some flowers, some metals, some resins. Even got some broken ones, but we're gonna hide that. That's no problem. So, let's start at the beginning. I'm gonna be very honest with you. I did lots of life. Mostly in my own safe group with people I know, and people that did see me do lives also know that I'm kind of a chaotic, unprepared, I call that working on intuition kind of girl. So now I have planned it and prepared it, so it's a bit scary for me. I will start with painting my canvas black with the Immix black gesso, and I have to say I'm a bit of a critical person when it comes to black gesso. I've tried out a number of brands, and I have to say I really love this one because it is not too thick. You can easily paint it on, but it does cover. One layer will do. So that's what I like about it. Hello, you there in Brazil. That's the most beautiful thing about this. Well, I don't call it a hobby anymore. It's more like a passion. With this hobby of ours, and with a bit of help of the internet, because the world seems a bit smaller nowadays. We can craft along with, India, Brazil, I'm in the Netherlands. I saw Kreia Red. She lives in Germany. She is a Dutch girl, but she lives in Germany. Just hopped over the border. You see, it's so easy to paint with it, and it's just one touch and you've got a black surface. I think this gesso should be available for everybody around the corner. Just a shop where you can pop in and say, hi, I need another jar of black gesso. especially for people that use a lot like me. But you can always order because the shipping is worldwide, I believe. No, I don't believe, I know. There's worldwide shopping. I've got another challenge today. I'm gonna try not to get up to my elbows in gesso and paints. I'm quite sure I'm gonna fail. See? I already started. Baby wipes. So, let's try that. I'm sorry, this does make a bit of a noise. I do have another one, but couldn't seem to find it. See? That's painted as well. It's almost dry. This is the only thing I'm gonna dry today, I think, so it's not that terrible. Yes. I put everything aside, but the things I need are at the bottom. See, it's just one layer. I painted it real quick and everything is black. And I think it's important to do your to paint your canvas black in advance because, well, let me show you. There will be all kinds of holes and things. And if you glued your embellishments on, it's not so easy to get your gesso under, so I always start with it. Let's do some texture paste. It's a small canvas, but it is a canvas. It's no problem if you do the same kind of thing on a bigger one, but because I will put on a lot of embellishments, I thought it would be boring for you if I took a bigger one. Because then it will take forever for me to glue all the embellishments on. This in the middle is not that important because we're gonna put all that other stuff up on top of it. So that will do. I have to clean up my stencil. Yes, texture paste. I'm using texture paste, but if you want some special effects, you can always take one of the other ones. I think the one with the glass beads gives a really nice effect. Sorry, I have to clean the stencil because otherwise. So that will do for now. I'm not going to dry this because I'm going to take advantage of the fact that it's still wet and start by adding some lace. It's a bit too big. And I want to make a canvas like this with all those layers. I usually start with what I call the flat stuff. So the lace and the things that aren't that dimensional. Yes, it is. A bit here. Hi Beatrice. So we've got someone from France in the house as well. Quite international today. You see, this will stick in the texture paste, it's no problem. I will close my jar. Because I won't be needing this anymore. Ooh, it's a small one. Well, I had a ruler here. It's small. It's just one size smaller than an A4. I did have something to measure with yesterday. I think that's enough of the lace thing. Get my elements out. So I will glue my flat pieces with the gel medium. And the bigger metal embellishments, I'm going to use the dimensional heavy gel. If you have any questions, please let me know. And I will try to answer them. So, what did I say? I say I always start with flat pieces. So this star is kind of flat. And I'm gonna put it here. I really don't have a system for this. I just take something and I glue it down somewhere where I think it is pretty. Already loving it. Just the texture paste and the black gesso. Well, maybe I should quit. Oh, and now I forgot something. I forgot my buttons. Why did I forget them? Or are they? No, are they here? I'm sorry. I just didn't show them. So, because why buttons? Well, because I want to have this flower raised. So I glue a button under there. So we get a dimensional effect. Bottle cap. Teeny tiny flower under there. Got a lot of flowers, I have to tell you that. Because I think that's nice flowers. I like flowers and I like cogs and gears. But before I go further, I'm gonna attach my chipboard. I cut it in half. And these chipboards from Expressions Craft, they are so delicate and beautiful, but the design is delicate. But they don't break easy, and that's good, because I told I don't know, I think I told Bafani, even I can't break them, so I'm with other chipboards. Sometimes I'm too enthusiastic and then when I want to get them out, I break them. And I can't seem to break this one, so they're perfect for me. You can bend them and work with them and don't have to be that careful. Favorite designs of what of the stencils you mean? I think they have a lot of pretty stencils. So. Let's just put that under there. I shouldn't have, because I said to you I'm gonna do the flat ones first, and what do? I go up. I have this big one that is cool. Well, I'm only using a few, but there really are so much beautiful designs in the webshop, in stencils and chipboards. You should take a look. And then you have to choose or buy everything. That's an option. You see, I shouldn't have done this, because now I have to lift it again. So let's do some more flowery stuff. I'm cutting a lot of these things in half. These kind of things, when I want them to go up like this. Then I'm using the, oh my goodness, now I have to, the dimensional heavy gel. Because they're not that heavy, but because they have to stay up, I'm asking a lot of them. So I need to be kind. I'm missing a flower. Where is it? Where is it? It's here. Well, I'm using metallics, but you don't have to use metallic stuff. Because you can just as easy glue on some other flowers. Like these, but I don't have a place for it yet. Why not do another star? Like this. So I have one here and I have one here with the flower, I have one here and I have one there. I am trying to balance it out a bit. But if you do differently, in this case, with these kind of canvases, it is no problem at all. You can just add and glue whatever you like. This is a cute one. I'm going to put it under that arrow. And if there are any gaps, that's no problem, because we will solve that with our deco stones. I just love that. If you work dimensional pieces, and then at the end, just fill out the gaps with the stones. And they give such a nice effect. So, I've got another star. No. Not that one. But as I said, you can use all kinds of flowers. Just whatever you've got, you know? Look what is in your stash and work with that. Because you can do buttons, you can use, well, what's the word for it? Bolts. Just go and see what kind of supplies your husband has. Let's do a bit of leaf. I'm gonna cut another flower. Oopsie. That's for the vacuum cleaner, I think. Come on. Get up. Little cock under there. Why not? I should use a little bit more glue. So, you see? And now I'm gonna hide it. Because I'm gonna add a button as well. So, yes. That should do the trick. Oh my god. Beatrice I think, is asking someone else in French why I have two jars with glue. Well, Beatrice, I'm gluing the lighter flatter parts with gel medium, and I am gluing the more heavy parts with dimensional heavy gel. That's why I have two jars. And why do I do that? Well, just because yes, now I'm looking for the English word, just because. Well, maybe I would like to last my jar of dimensional heavy gel forever. I think that's just about why I do that. It isn't possible, I know, but I can always try. I'm gonna put another flower. I'm gonna bend it a bit. And as I finish, you will see it's not exactly the same as the other one. But that is just something I can't do. I cannot make exactly the same thing twice. I don't know where this came from, but I think it's a fun piece. Why not put that here for a change? Because of the other one, they're both at the bottom. Well, thank you so much, dear. But if you don't have metals, you can use other ones as well. You just have to think in possibilities. What can I use? What do I have? And if you don't have enough flowers, Expressions Craft has some wonderful flowers in their webshop. Real pretty flowers. Shall we do the heart over here? No, we're not going to do the heart. Why do you ask? I always do that. I ask something and when you all say left and I go right. People who know me, they take advantage of that. Because if they want me to go right, they say, well, please go left. Oh, thank you, dear. I'm trying to be a bit quicker because I can imagine it's a bit boring to look at, so. I was just thinking to put something under this key because it's a bit thick and it won't stay in place. So let's do a button under there. Yes. You see, now it stops wiggling. This thing was wiggling, and it shouldn't be. some smaller flowers. Got my leaf. Nope. Shall we do something? Oh my goodness, my phone is ringing. It shouldn't be. I really don't know who it is. But the next time they call, my phone won't be ringing. I'm sorry about that. It never rings. Nobody calls me. So? Almost there, I think. Looking for a few smaller flowers. So, I am gonna turn it upside down to see if there's not too much space I didn't use. No, that's okay. So, then I'm gonna put this aside. And then we're gonna add the stones. No, no magic yet, dear. I'm gonna start with the big ones. They really have very, very pretty flowers. But you know, I have one over here, and I'm kind of, you know, aren't they too pretty to paint black? That's my problem. Oh, I'm sorry. Something should happen. It always does with me. So why didn't it? Oh my goodness. Well, let's just pick them up from here. I start with the bigger ones and then I'm going to use the little ones. And I thought I'm not going to sprinkle them because I'm going to have a deco stone party then. And now I do it with a brush and they're still all over the place. So let's hope this was my blooper for the day. I always have one, at least. You know, if there's anyone who's gonna put his brush in his coffee or something, it will always be me. I am used to that. But I wasn't prepared for this one. I just found a little leafy thing, so that can go here. Why not? Yes, deco stones. But I'm sure someone will post the link for you to find them in the web shop. So now with this whole thing that a lot of us are sitting at home, working from home or not allowed to go out, I have to tell you, I am allowed to go out. We still are in the Netherlands. But if we're not allowed anymore, I'm still allowed because I do work as a nurse, so I will always be allowed to go to work. Let's leave it at that. But for now, here in the Netherlands, you can still go out and you can still visit the store. The real big stores have all closed down, but some are still open. Well, I clean that in a minute. Let's close the jar. I think they're so cool, deco stones, you know, because like I said, it gives so much extra texture to your project. You just have to be careful not to get what I did just now. And I'm doing it again, you know, this thing is here, my arm is there, so I should put it over here. I think that just might be better. Because if I'm gonna stream again, so let's close this. The small ones I am gonna sprinkle because I'm gonna do some touches of the gel medium here and there. So doing it again. I'm making my own disaster. I don't need anything to go with that. But that's okay. Maybe one day I can tell my grandkids, well, you know, your granny was such a disaster. I've got hours of bloopers to come your way. Well, I'm gonna put this aside for just a minute and then I'm gonna clean this. Well, in this case, because I'm working with a black gesso, I already added them to my project, but what also gives a very nice effect is to cover your project in gesso first, then add the stones and give them some color with a liquid kind of paint, a watercolor, or just use the chroma burst with some water, you know. Just clean these stones, they won't do what I want. And they have to, because I want to save them. They're gonna go back in the jar when I'm finished. Whether they want to or not. Because I'm in charge here, and not dead stones. So, let's go over the bin. Yeah. Yes, save them all. So that's a bonus tutorial. How to save your deco stones. Well, this is it. And you should think we were gonna dry this and paint it black. Well, I am gonna do that later. As I said, I came prepared today. So I already have one that is covered in black gesso. So you don't have to watch me making everything black, because that's pretty boring. At least I think so. When I watch a video tutorial and I see someone painting everything black, that's my time to get a cup of coffee or something. So, I'm going to start with the chalk paint. I've got a lavender and I've got a baby pink. So, let's start with the pink one. You don't need that much. And I am applying my paint with a makeup brush. I think that works just fine. And I'm gonna dry brush. I'm gonna take the big circle. See how much you cover with just a teeny tiny bit of paint. If you have any questions, just let me know. And now you can see all those layers. Something has come off. Just turning it a bit. And this is the lavender. And that is such a pretty color. Well, I think it works. Yeah. I like working with these brushes. These makeup brushes. We had a good laugh because I went to a store to buy a few sets of those makeup brushes. And then I got home and my daughter said, "Why did you buy makeup brushes? You don't even, I never see you with any makeup." And then I laughed and she said, "Oh, I already know. You're gonna make mixed media brushes out of them." And she was so right. Well, these brushes are soft, but I just like them. So, thank you, Karen. That's our first layer. I'm gonna go into the sides a bit, I'm sorry. So, thank you, Rani. Well, I did see someone use makeup brushes for waxes. And then I thought, why not do it for paints? It is, you know, they're short. A lot of hairs. I don't know. Love it, love it, love it. Let's do some paints. And let's just start with the purple affair. Oh my goodness. And these are so pretty, these metallics. Oh, really? See what happens. La, 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 la. Don't you just love them? They're so shiny. And so easy to apply. Hey, you see how much I can paint with just one? I only dipped my lid once. And I'm still picking up paint to put on my project. So, when you're using it for dry brushing, these jars are gonna last you forever. And that's okay, because if they last long, you can buy more colors. My boyfriend would say, you can buy less paint. No, you can buy more colors. Which color is this? This is the Tuscan Red. I am using all kinds of reds today, or related to the reds, so they will not get into arguments with each other, these colors. If you don't know which colors to combine, just choose them within the same family, and then it shouldn't be a problem. Yes, the ones I'm using right now are all metallics. I used two chalk paints, the baby pink and the lavender, and now I'm using metallic paints. And I used the purple affair, and this is the Tuscan Red. And it will get crazier. Because also a family of red is orange, and that's my next color. Let's just see what the official. Oh, it's carrot skin. Yes, of course, I'm only using Imix metallics for this project, and they have such yummy, yummy, yummy colors. So, let's do the carrot skin. And you might say pink and orange. Well, pink and orange go very well together. Look, they're real good friends. You see, orange on pink and purple is cool. I love it. Just give that bit of extra. Let's do a pinky. another Pinky. Pinky Toes. I just love those names. Who would have thought that Carrot Skin and Pinky Toes were going to meet each other in Canvas? Not Kansas, but Canvas. And I'm trying with this lighter one to touch the highest parts of the composition. See? And did you see how little paint I used? As I said, you really don't need much. So let's close the pinky toes. And I've got only one color left. And that's the Daisy Heart. And yes, I know that's not related to the pinkies and the red ones. But hey, it is a little brother of this orange one, so I think it can work. I'm only gonna do a quick touch with this. Just some edges here and there, not too much. See? They're my family. And the Daisy Heart, this is not a metallic, this is a shimmer metallic. So I should give you the right information. Yep. And I'm gonna take, I forgot to get some water. I'm gonna solve this. This is dirty. Because I want splatter and I need some water for that. Cool. No, this is not water. This is stupid. I thought I had everything. I'll just be a minute to get some water. I'm sorry. I'm back. Well, that was blooper number two. I'm almost done, so it's not gonna get any worse. Even kijken. Kwastje. My brushes were so dirty. And then I don't mean this, but this here. That I thought I get a new set out just for you. Ooh, let's start with the pinkies. So, I will take some paint, and then I'm going to add some water, fresh water, just got it from the tap, because I forgot to have it ready. Just water down the paint, and because otherwise we have this big black hole in the middle. So, that's one. I'm gonna repeat that with the black, with the Tuscan red. And maybe orange. What did they use in the other one? I don't know. Well, for starters, cleaning will be a great idea. I'm not too good at that. Yeah. What did I say? Which color? Should we do the orange one? So, a bit of paint. Thank you, Ashana. Water. A bit of orange splatters. Now, there's only one thing left for me to do, and that is choose the sentiment, paint it, and put it on. So, what will we do? Let's do inspire. You see, that's what I mean. I'm taking it off and I'm not able to demolish it. So it's good quality chipboard. If I can't break it, no one can. Nope, not gonna do that like this. Sorry. Get some more paint. I'm just trying to figure out what color I will use, and I think I'm gonna go for the lavender, the chalk paint. To try if this will work, because I don't want it opaque. I want it a bit more like this. Yes, it works. So I'm doing this with a baby wipe. Yes. I'm gonna take some glue. Put it on my text. And just put it here. And now I think I'm done. So, what have we got? I always have baby wipes all over the place. So, in a nutshell, today, this is what the example was, this is what we made, and I still have this one. But this one still has to dry and has to be painted black. And maybe, just maybe, I will choose some other colors for this one. Maybe I'm gonna go for the blues and the greens, which is a real nice family as well. And maybe I put on the camera while I give it color and make a video out of it for you, so you can see what the result will be when you use other colors. But that's it for now. Thank you so much for helping me through this. And I hope you can forgive me one, two bloopers. I will do the best again to make it one next time. I mean, no bloopers at all, then it wouldn't be me. That's my signature. Make one big blooper. And if you have any questions, please let me know. Do check out the website for all those gorgeous products. Maybe I can show you the colors I used one more time. These are the metallics. I have this carrot skin, purple passion, Tuscan red, and pinky toes. I will never forget that name, pinky toes. I'm not a big pink girl, but pinky toes, hey. And this is a shimmer metallic paint, the Daisy Heart. I use two chalk paints, the lavender and the pink. Baby pink. This is baby pink, pinky toes. Don't forget, know your pinks. The texture paste. The art gel medium matte for the flatter, lighter stuff. And my other jars disappeared. The dimensional heavy gel for the bigger metals, so they will stick to the canvas. The Art Essentials heavy gesso. And my blooper for today. The deco stones, I used three sizes of them. I used the mega, the medium, and the mini. They will go right back into my little chart. And yeah, well, I used some chipboard pieces as well, and the stencil. And I'm sorry, I really don't know the name of this. Forgive me. When I make a video, I look it up, what the name of the stencil is, so it's easier to find for you on the website. But maybe some of the other girls can tell you which stencil this is. And of course these chipboard quotes. Well, I think I just, yeah, that will cover it. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.